Here, teacher name, teach tell depends on the part of the primary key, which is teacher ID. Therefore, the table is not in 2NF. Therefore, table is not in 2NF. Right, please write down this part of the primary key. Primary key ki kota sab matter anda apavati no the teacher ID matter anda apavati no teacher name telephone number ekena partial dependence mokada deka me ekathu karala daagatte denna mata mana anda apavati habai ehema nathuwa ekkenek matter anda apavati inn giyama api kiyena eka e wade honda ne that is not good eka hariyata den oyage ammai taattai mata tama paula randa apavati inn kiyala api hita ganna habai oya karana samahara wada this relationship is not really strong. Because you depend on your mother only. You don't listen to your father. That is not good. You have to listen to both mother and father. So that is why you assign a composite primary key. Okay, if you don't have composite primary key, if you don't have composite primary key, so whether is this table in 2NF? If table is in 1NF, okay, listen carefully. If table is in 1NF and no composite primary key, only one single primary key is there, then is table in 2NF? Hari, imrisi therenne anne single enga kanda. Table ekak tiyena, table ekak 1NF. Table like a primary key ekak tiyena. Eka composite nemeyi. Ehema nan table ekak 2NF da. Yes or no? Come on. Is it yes or no? Table is there, that is in 1NF. And then table is there, that is in 1NF, and no composite primary key. It's a single primary key. Then table is in 2NF. Because 2NF issue is the partial dependency. The partial dependency when composite composite partial dependency. Okay, think like that. Some are there. Yeah, their father is maybe not there, or mother is not there. They have a single parent. Maybe due to separation or due to widowed status. So there's a single parent, then. So you have to listen only that parent. So no partial dependencies. So no, that is in 2NF. Okay. So that is special point. Please understand that if a table is in 1NF and primary key is not, is if primary key is not a composite key, but it is a single key, then there is no room for partial dependencies. There is no room for partial dependencies. Table in 2NF. So 2NF issue comes only when there is a 2NF issue ekak enne composite key ekak tibbot vitarai. Ehema naththam 2NF enne. 1NF thiyenona aniwaryama 2NF. Okay. So then we understood what is 1NF, what is 2NF. Have you finished writing or still doing? I have given enough examples, right? So this part I think you have not understood very well due to some error. You didn't understand what is partial dependency. You didn't understand what is. Okay, next is like 3NF. 3NF issue. Okay, to solve this, what you can do is you can do something like this. To solve this, you can divide this to two tables. Solution. I assume that you have written, right? Because you are not talking, so I'm also not interested in repeatedly talking to you. So if you don't want to talk, so let's forget that. Let's say solution is like you can write teacher ID and the particular class of the teacher, teacher ID and class in one. So let's remove these two and introduce a new one with teacher ID. There is one. This is not required now. Sorry. One, two, three. Now this is in. Let's remove this also. Now this table in 2NF. The above tables are in 2NF. The above tables are in 2NF. Please write down the solution. So this was the problem that we faced because we had partial dependencies. These keys are depending on teacher ID only. Hari ehema nan den onna teerneyak gatta. Hari oyala ahanne amma kiyana de nan ammat ekkama inda. So something like that. Right. Okay, two parties are ruling the country, but some parties only depend on the one party, one president or one maybe prime minister or someone. So they decide to separate. They are uniting just for some cases, but others like they hand over, okay. So you take over these parts and look after them. Clear separation. Now actually, so together there's a primary key to link the class. Primary key and foreign key relationship here. Actually composite primary key, no matter, no issue because no one to depend on them. Now only like president and prime minister. So they are talking to each other. They may take decisions. They are doing their work. They are doing their work together. No other one involved in their duties. So no fight. Right? So the people involved in their duties, people who depends on their duties, they are managing separately. No harm. Right? So that is how the solution came. So my question, is it in 3NF? So are these tables in 3NF? Are these tables in 3NF? What is your answer? Yes or no? If yes, why? If no, why? So please respond. At least okay, you're not talking, but send it to the chat. Then I can understand whether you have any idea about these dependencies. Are these tables in 3NF? I agree with Umesh, there are no partial dependencies, but 3NF is not depends on the partial dependencies, right? 3NF for Umesh, it already ekak thawa ekak balana. Transitive dependency kiyala ekak balana. Right? Etakota Gihan kiyana not in 3NF due to transitive dependency. Correct Gihan, mokadda transitive dependency? Transitive dependency means none key is depend on none key. Key ekak nona kenek, key ekak nona kenek mata dependent. Again, me amma taatha inna pawule palane karana. Mother and father, or president and vice president, or president and prime minister is there to control the parliament. But some ministers are dependent on some other ministers. The external relationships. Right? That is so bad. Right? no partial dependencies. Yeah, no partial dependency. I agree with that. So we are now, it's in 2NF. But there are transitive dependencies. That means, so ministers are dependent on ministers. Ministers are not listening to the prime minister or president. So they have their own community. They are depending on each other. Right? So that can be another problem. Or in your family, you are not depending on, you are depending on mother and father, yes, but there are some other dependencies also. Maybe you depend on your brother depend on you or sister. Maybe likewise, you are having your own secrets and you do the way you like. Without, that is not notable for your primary keys. That is also not good. Then also, that's a relationship issue. So yes, there are transitive. So here, the answer is no. There are transitive dependencies. So what are the transitive dependency? Transitive dependency is comes when a non-key depends on another non-key. So where that issue is there? Example, you can say telephone number teacher tell depends on teacher name. Right? Teacher tell depends on teacher name. Telephone number ka nama anu dependent. If Gihan, this is the telephone number. Menaka, this is the telephone number. Then Shehan. So based on telephone number also, you can identify the teacher name. If this is, then that number is belongs to Gihan. So the other way also. And the name depends on T. So therefore, this is not in pre-NF. Right? So due to this dependency, the table is not in pre-NF. So only solution is you can divide this table to teacher ID, teacher class, then teacher ID, teacher name, and teacher ID, teacher tab. Three tables. But sometimes it seems like too much. So here, so you can decide either because teacher name depend on teacher tell and teacher tell depend on teacher name. You don't want to think much about that. Even though that is not in pre-NF, that is manageable. So you can ignore that. Okay. Even though that is not in pre-NF, that is manageable, that is understandable. So you can just ignore that. And by ignoring, you can process. Right? So then actually you don't want to update this to pre-NF. You can keep it as, because if you divide this further, teacher ID, teacher name, then teacher tell, teacher ID. So that is like too many relationships. That is also not required. Therefore, you can keep it as it is. Right? Sometimes it is not needed to implement. So that level of relationship, but some are clearly. So for an example, so let's say you have a table like this. I'm going to have a table, another table, teacher ID and teacher name, teacher last name. And then I'm going to introduce another column, insert, write, another to write. Right. So let's say, so let's see unnecessary 3NF issue, or maybe the 3NF issue which need to be solved. So teacher, maybe teacher name, and let's add another one, teacher name, gender. Kyan male, Menaka female, and Shehan male. So this is not a dependency now. This is not partially dependent or transitive dependency because male nang aniwaryen gihan nemeni shehan uppinnone me. Inda gihan nang aniwaryen male kiyala hema thing apita ganna awashyath naha. E patta da ehenda meke echchara consider karanna one nathi 3NF case ekak. Habai api tham mehema CT and postport. So let's say Gihan from Kandy. So what is the postport Kandy? Let's say 20,000. And Menaka is from Kandy. Then it's also 20,000. She's also 20,000. And let's say Shayan from Gampa. And postal code is 11,000. So now you can see the postal code depends on city. Here, postal code depends on city. So table has a transitive dependency. And it needs to be solved. The solution is you can divide this to two tables. The solution is you can divide this to two tables. Here you can keep the postal code and just cut this. You don't want and introduce a new one. Insert. Okay. There you can add let's delete the columns and insert another one to left, and you can have the postal code. So this is how you are going to solve this kind of problem. But for the previous one, you don't want to worry much because that is not a big dependency, but you can ignore that. But this one, of course, you have to solve. Okay, so here's the solution. So now you don't have any, now you don't have any transitive dependencies. Please write that, show that. Above there, it's that there are no transitive dependencies. Which pute, Umesh? This one. This one has transitive dependency. Teacher tell depend on teacher name and teacher name depend on teacher tell. It has transitive dependency, right? But need not to be solved. That is not strong enough. That is not affecting much. This transitive, so I'll write here, this transitive dependency is not much affecting on anomalies, or not much leading, or not much leading to anomalies. So that's why we are not going to solve. But this one will lead anomalies. Anomalies කියලා කියන්නේ අපි හදිස්සියේවත් වෙනස් කරොත් කැන්ඩි වල postal code එක. So why? Because here actually if you change the number of Gihan, so that you have to update නේ. Gihan ගේ number එක වෙනස් කරොත් ඒක update කරන්න ඕන. හැබැයි Gihan ආයේ පල්ලෙහා කොහෙවත් නැහැ නේ. හින්දා එක තැනක් update කළා shape වෙන්න පුළුවන්. Gihan ගේ number එක වෙනස් වුණොත් update කරන්න වෙනවා. ඒක එක තැනක විතරනේ update කරන්න යන්නේ. හැබැයි කැන්ඩි වල postal code එක වෙනස් වුණොත් teachers ලා अभी तो टीचर्स स्टाफ के हतली हाँ हतली हम विस कैंडी कैंडी वाले पोस्टल कोड अपडेट करना 40 टीचर्स आउट ऑफ 40 टीचर्स 20 आर फ्रॉम कैंडी नाउ सो कैंडी पोस्टल कोड हैज चेंज्ड नाउ हाउ मेनी अपडेट्स नीडेड एटलीस्ट यू हैव टू अपडेट 20 दैट इज अ वेरी लार्ज अमाउंट सो दैट इज अपडेशन एनोमली देयरफॉर यू कैन डिवाइड दिस टू टू टेबल्स. Now, Kandy postal code has changed. Now, assume that Kandy postal code has changed. You have to update the postal code. According to the postal code update, so because the postal code is foreign key here, this will be automatically updated. But, if you update it automatically, you have to update foreign key. මෙතන අප්ඩේට් කරද්දි මැනුවලි ඔක්කොම අප්ඩේට් කරා. හැබැයි මෙතන අප්ඩේට් කරනකොට ඒකට අදාළ ෆොරින් කීස් ඔක්කොම අප්ඩේට් that is called cascade update. That is why the second one need to be solved. The first one need not to be solved because no repeating values, so no need to worry much. But yes, there are repeating values also, so you have to solve this. Okay, you can draw this, show this, and that is about the. So I have done full theory lesson, but don't expect this kind of thing in a revision class next day, right? So because you are not responding, I did that. But next day, even though you respond or not, I'll ignore because the thing is, you purposely ignoring responding. Italam wala kata karanne. Kathari mama danne, mama hitanne, ogolo oya kata karanne thuyine joliye kiyala. Therefore, I'm not going to teach you these theory parts because it will take more time to explain a question. Finish writing. Then I owe you a good answer. Then that is jolly. Clearly, what is the question? What is the answer? The answer is very fast. Have you finished writing? Yes or no? Gihan has finished writing, others I think sleepy. Sidmi, have you finished writing? Netuli, have you finished writing?
Yes, sir.
Why are you not responding then?
Finished writing, sir. Okay.
Then let's move to the next one. The question. The question says, oh, this is not the question. Okay, which of the following statements is about relation in the second normal form is true? It can have a composite key, true. It should be a first normal form as well, yes, true. All non-key attributes are fully functionally depend on the primary key. All non-key attributes fully functionally depend on primary key, true. So what is the answer for this one? All non-key attributes fully functionally depend on primary key. Yes, that means no partial dependencies in other hand, right? And should be in the first normalization form, right? It can have a composite key. That is also true. So all A, B, C are true. Which of the following statements regarding logical database schema are true? It is a blueprint of database. It contains data and information. It formulates all constraints that are to be applied to the applied on data. Logical database schema. So it formulates all constraints that are to be applied to data. It contains data and information. It is a blueprint for a database. Out of this, which are true? Yes, what is your answer? 28. Tell me your answer. Which of the following statements are true? Yes, I'm waiting for your answer. 28. Yes, the first one says it is a blueprint. Blueprint means a template. That is true. So A is true. So answers with A all are true. So, but we don't know about the second. Let's say analyze the second. It contains data and information. Yes, in the logical database schema, you have data and information. So in any place, you have data and information. In logical data schema also, the logical database schema also, data and information are there. So B is also true. So you can get answers. Now there are two answers, 2 and 5. It formulates all constraints that are to be applied to data. Actually, it should formulate, but it formulates all constraints. What do you think? To be applied to data. constraints. Constraints means the primary key constraints, foreign key constraints should be introduced. Yes, but it formulates all. The problem is with all. It formulates the constraints. Keyword hari all kila keyword hai all formulate in all naman hai. Therefore, I'll keep this as a blank. Maybe like this is partially correct. Therefore, I'm going to select the second answer. But I don't know. Maybe in the examination they have given marks for fifth one also. Okay, let's see how they have given marks. I'm interested in looking at that. So where's the marking schema? Here it is. Okay, the question number 27. 28. Question number 28. They have selected third one. Oh, they have selected third one. Formulates all constraints. Contains data and information, but it contains data and information. So why they have dropped that? So that is a problem. So they have selected third one, which is AZ only. But here, this is what logical data schema is. Logical database schema. In anything, so this is the logical database schema. Right? I'll show using this. It's a conceptual model, it's a blueprint. So it is where the ER diagrams and all comes from, right? Here, logical database schema define all logical constraints that need to be applied to the data stores. It defines tables, views, integrity constraints. Right here, they have taken all, I think due to this, all logical constraints that need to be applied. It defines tables, views, integrity constraints, but tables, views, integrity constraints has data and information. Actually, data inserting and all is not done. So, but this interprets wrong, this give wrong idea. That is the thing. Data and information kiyana ke meegola adahas karanne meke table ekak athule thiyena data na ewanne etana ඒක ද අදහස් කරන්නේ data and information කියන ඕනම තැනක තියෙන data and information define data එක හඳුන්වලා දෙන්නත් පාවිච්චි කරන constraint related data those are also data and information so my answer will go to either 5 or 205 but anyway so this won't come again but in case if it comes this is correct it's a blueprint for sure this is correct it's a blueprint it's a template Right, logical database schema is a template. But what is physical database schema? Physical database schema is basically actually storage and data and its storage files and all. So that is called physical database schema, where it is stored and all. Here, the table names. This is called logical database schema. Physical database schema means the files, disk, where it stores. Make a data nahi kiyana eka nam ithin boruwak. It contains data nahi kiyanne mehema data item nahi yani data enter karapu ewa nahi eth ithin data and information tama meka tiyenne this question is not a fair question okay so consider the following sql statement alter table subject add primary key subject id which of the following is incorrect about the sql statements okay so read the question and give your answer first 29 What is the answer for question number 29? Please give it. I'm waiting till you answer. Okay. So one has given 4, one has given 3, one has given 5, one has given 1. So you are trying all the possibilities. I'm happy about that, right? Okay. Alter table student at primary key subject ID, which is incorrect about the about SQL statement. Incorrect. It adds primary key constraint to the table name subject. Table name subject key. La table like that. You know, old table subject add primary key. Arne, it adds primary key constraint to table name subject. The table name subject should already exist. Table like that. You know, the table like that. Because I'm going to add Karan. Why? Because the ekka varadi key arne. Why? Dekka varadi key arne. Why? Dekha thari. A table field subject ID should not be null. Primary key is not null. That's field subject ID should not be null. That is also true. So Achintha, subject ID should not be null, should not be empty. Primary key cannot be empty. A table name subject is created with a primary key name. A table name subject is created. A table name subject is created with the primary key name. No. That is wrong. A table name subject is created. So answer is 4. Asking about incorrect one, no? So answer is 4. The value of the field subject ID should not be repeated. Yes. Primary key cannot be repeated. So 5 is not answer, Umesh. Primary key cannot be repeated. It is correct. That is correct. Should not be null. That is also correct. I think you have a big gap in the database. So I can see by looking at the answers. Anyway, fourth one is wrong. So that is given by only one student, unfortunately. Right? You have a big gap in database. So I don't know why. So please rethink why you have given this answer. Do you need any help to understand this concept? They're asking incorrect. Key at our table, old table again, table like a hadenine is created. A table name subject is created. Create when in a table, old table subject, add primary key. So I have a few videos uploaded, not few videos, actually more videos uploaded related to database. Please go through that. So I think you have lacking knowledge in the particular area. So I have already done that. Please go through the videos, right? You missed with the correct and incorrect. So that is the thing. Again, correct, incorrect, miskaragatut, you're right. It adds the primary key. Constraint to the table name subject, correct. Subject already exists, correct. Not null and not repetitive. That is also correct. But subject is created. No, it's incorrect. Consider the following scenario about books and about authors and books to answer the questions from 30 to 31. An author can write books. Author can write books. So normally, how do you take this? If disconnect, please rejoin, right? If disconnect with this session, please rejoin because I have to discuss 30 and 31 too, that is related to database because today let's finish the database part. Right. An author can write books. A book has title and code called ISBN, which is unique. Namapadayak tiyenona api ekata kiyana entity ekak. A noun is entity. If noun is described further, it is entity. If noun is there but not described further, that is attribute. Noun ekak thiyenona eka vistara karala thiyenona entity ekak. Noun ekak thiyenona vistara karala neha, ehema nan attribute ekak. Action ekak, process ekak thiyenona nan eka relationship ekak. Okay. Author can write is relationship. Author can write author books, both are nouns. A book has a title and code called ISBN, which is unique. ISBN unique, again, ISBN is the primary key, so unique, as it has title and book. A book can be written by either one or several authors, one to many. One book can be written by many authors. An author has name and